In Japan, almost half of unmarried people under the age of 34 are virgins, like actual virgins. In fact, the vast majority aren't in any kind of relationships, and it's actually a huge problem. The population is in decline. The number of kids that were born hit record lows. In fact, it's such an aging population that the number of adult diapers is about to outsell babies' diapers. So, the lack of sex in Japan has been blamed on a whole bunch of things. Porn, anime, robots, of course, it's always robots. But what if sex itself isn't the main issue here? What if it's just the symptom of a much bigger problem?
今やってる仕事はすごく楽しくて充実しているので、世界に出ていきたいなと思いますし、結婚も両立できるように頑張りたいと思ってます。
Oda Ayame is 25. She's got a good corporate job, and today she is on a hunt. A little bit for handbags, but mostly for a husband. She's getting ready to go to a kind of speed dating event.
いい人には出会いたいんですけど、なかなか出会えないです。
Dating is big business in Japan. The government is spending millions of dollars to help people like Oda find a partner. There are taxpayer-funded dating services and a booming industry of spouse hunting events called kunkatsu, where applicants can sometimes even be screened on looks and earnings. And then there's this. This is an all-singing, all-dancing, all-pouting instructional video for women looking to attract a keeper. It shows you the sexiest joints to expose, what grade stockings to wear, and even the most mathematically attractive angle to tilt your head. Still, the women do generally get into these events at no cost.
Do you think it's fair?
公平です。日本では公平です。
Oda is looking for a serious man, someone who's real marriage material.
いただきます。
And somehow I question whether bringing a random Australian along as a wingman is going to help, but here goes.
日本人は少しシャイなので、気軽に女の子に声かけるとか、男の人に声かけるっていうのができないの。
Where do the serious men live?
それを探してます。
Are you telling me that you won't find a serious man playing with the plastic toy at the bar?
多分結構いると思う。
And so, why would you have essentially a child's toy at a dating venue? Oh, drinking it. Okay. So I'm just keeping up my end of the bargain. I'm going to step out. You guys keep enjoying yourselves. Food is on the way. So the deal is that girls get in for free and guys pay about 1,500 yen per 30 minutes. So that's, I don't know, somewhere between 15 and 18 Australian dollars per 30 minutes. However, you get this complete self-service bar, which is not at all a recipe for binge drinking. The best part is this thing. Watch this. Who needs bartenders? Of course, you need extra hand. It's a magical place. Magical, expensive place.
While Oda had a good time, no luck this evening. 60% of young Japanese women are tonight single, and 70% of young men. Ayame remains one of millions of people tonight sleeping alone.
こう、just 私もすごく言うので、みんな嫌になりますね。だんだん強い女性にストロンガー強い女性になってしまうので。
Today we're having lunch at Nadeshiko Sushi, which is Japan's first and only sushi restaurant completely run by women. In fact, this woman, Yuki Chizui.
Take me back to 2010 when you started at this place, because I understand it was a reaction to the recession.
2010年は日本がリーマンショックという不況。経済的にちょっと落ち込んでいた時だったんですね。でその時に女性の雇用からだんだん切られていくっていう現状があって、そしてそこで始めようっていう思いで。
Nadeshiko Sushi is a reference to the ideal Japanese female, a lady of tradition, of feminine grace and domesticity. And despite being a pioneer, a business owner and just insanely talented at making amazing looking and tasting sushi, 31-year-old Yuki also cannot get a date.
なんかみんなうわーってなりますよね。仕事の癖でこのままもう言ってしまうと向こうはがっかりみたいになっちゃいます。
Several high-profile male chefs or itame have argued that women are incapable of making sushi because their hands are too warm or that their menstrual cycle ruins their sense of smell and taste.
When you hear somebody say that women can't be sushi makers because their hands are too warm, what goes through your head?
まあ、なんか理由をつけて、女性が入らないような世界にしたいっていう思い、男の社会、かっこいいみたいな。
Why is it that Japanese men can't deal with an independent woman that can have her own opinions about the world?
まあ、まずはお金の問題で、昔は90年代とかバブルファッションとかはもう強くても綺麗できらびやかでナイスバディな女性が流行っていたんですね。でそういう女性はやっぱお金持ちの方とこう釣り合うような雰囲気ですけど、今もう年収400万円時代でどんどん低収入になると、その自分の威厳を保つためには自分より弱い存在のものを作り上げて、こう痩せてて細くて、そこの秋葉原のAKB とかメイドさんのようなふわっとした存在の方にこうだんだんだんだんこうね退化していくっていう思いだと思います。
Yuki is talking about Tokyo's maid cafe girls in the Akihabara district where she runs her restaurant. Inspired by manga and anime, the girls dress up like these cartoon characters and they're paid to fawn over customers.
なんか日本、例えば普通のオフィスで考えたらセクハラとかをそのまま受け入れて謙虚に当たり前と思いなさいと。
For what it's worth, it seems Yuki is also not that thrilled with the idea of kankatsu parties and the pressure they put on women to dress and act in a certain way.
外見の中ではなんかふわふわした柔らかそうなニットを着てこう優しい女性を演出っていうのが一つと、もう一つはいつも笑顔でうんうんって聞いてあげる女性がもうそれ大和なでしこじゃないですけど素敵っていう二つはびっくりしましたね。それならなんかぬいぐるみでこう今しゃべるね、相槌を打つぬいぐるみの方がコスパがいいんじゃないかとは思いますけど、人である意味がない。
A soft toy instead of an actual personJapan is famed for its kink culture. There's a multi-billion dollar industry of hostess bars, fetish clubs, masturbation clubs, love hotels, and yes, sex shops. And yet, virginity is on the rise. The numbers of people who've never had sex with someone else have been growing for the past 20 years. And at the top of this building is a woman who has been tackling this problem very hands-on. Online, she's known as Queen Love. Ai Ayama is a kind of sex therapist.
Oh, wow.
Tokyo Tower.
Oh, my goodness. It's amazing.
男性の遊ぶところも多いんですね。面倒くさい思いして恋人を作ったりとか。
Ayama sees men mostly in their 20s and 30s, and it's largely about getting them comfortable with bodies. Theirs and others.
How do they react when you hug them? There's a lot of men and women that are entering their 30s in this country without having any sexual experience.
そうですね、まあ今の若い人たちはバーチャルの世界で日本は本当に可愛い人たちがいるんですね。ですから生身の人間だと怖いし反抗もするしっていうことで、
The population is dropping, the amount of young people getting into relationships is dropping. It's becoming quite a serious problem. Are you worried about the future of your country?
はい、心配です。それで私が少子化の解決策として思っているのが、もうこうなったらしょうがないんで、一夫多妻制で優秀な男性のところに女性が群がって、その人の子孫をみんな作ればいいんじゃないか。
Didn't expect that as an answer.
In a previous life, Ayama was a dominatrix.
もう躊躇なくオープンにできます。
Her clients were largely stressed out salary men who were being yelled at in the office. But they liked being her slave.
その奴隷というか M 男性たちの闇の深さを見て、そして もう私がこう縛ったりとか鞭を振ったりすることで、相手の人がもう本当に外の仕事で厳しかったりするのが癒されるのが目に見えて分かってきて、これはカウンセリングにできるなって言って。
So you could see the stress that their work life had on them. What do you think that tells you about Japan's working culture?
夜中の12時過ぎるのが当たり前な業界もありますし、もう本当にこのままではどんどん少子化とか悪い方向に。
Is Queen Love right? Up next, is the key to solving Japanese sex about fixing how Japan works?
理想の女性像は家に帰った時に何か癒しの空間を作ってくれる人が一番いいですかね。
Taiyo Hashimoto is known in Japan as a salaryman. He's 26, upwardly mobile, ambitious, and he would love a date. But work comes first.
まあやっぱ仕事は夜の7時に終わって、でも結局残業することが基本的に毎日で、でやっぱそれでこう結局帰るのが終電だったりとか。
Japan is world famous for its work ethic and the pressure to perform is high. Taiyo says you don't leave work before the boss, and if the boss wants to go out for a drink, you do too.
上司と飲みに行った時に感じるプレッシャーとしては、まあやっぱいただいたものは基本的には飲まなきゃいけないんで、やっぱお酒が強い人と行くと結構こちらとしては合わせなきゃいけないので大変ですね。一杯飲んだら合わせて一杯飲んでおかわり一緒に頼む、それが結構マナーというか、そういうのが常識なのです。
But for many of these salarymen, it's not just about the drinking.
まあ風俗店にはやっぱ会社で飲んでて、まあみんな酔っ払ってちょっとやっぱ行こうよってなったりとか、日本の男性陣の中ではよくある話であって、で逆になんかこういうタイプと会ったとか、出てきたらすごいのがいたとかっていう会話を楽しんだりするのも一つ、あったりはしますね。
Shimbashi in Tokyo is one of the top salarymen after hours hangouts. The food is cheap and the drinks are plentiful
We are in a, like the hub of salaryman drinking culture right now, and the reason there's so many people behind me is because the last train is about to leave and it's just coming up on midnight. And there's a lot of drunk people around.
But before that last train goes, I'm curious to find out what these men, and it is mostly men, think of the women in their lives, or the lack thereof.
割とその自分の好きなことやりたいタイプなので、そういうところを許容してくれる女性が割と理性ですかね。
わかります。
それはその上で可愛くて、まあ、スタイルが良かったらまあ最高ですね。
わかりました、
はい、男はちゃんと働く、女は、はい、ちゃんと子供を育てる、はい、そういう働き方。
ちょっと大企業はだいぶ女性の社会進出を支えようとしているんですけども、はい、まあ、ちょっと大企業よりも一歩劣る会社なので、はい、まだちょっと男性が働いて女性が専業主婦みたいな考えが残っていて、はい、ただ私は嫁の方が稼いでるぐらいの感じなんで、嫁の方がいっぱい働いてるし。
Women's participation in Japan's workforce hit an all-time high last year.The government's so-called womenomics is pushing for more ladies to top up the country's shrinking workforce.
どうしてもやっぱリーマン弾けてから日本のやっぱ個人の所得とかも不安定だったりしてるのがまだ根強いかなっていうイメージですね。なので共働きしてくれる女性の方がお互いにまあ安定的になれるっていうところで。
The thing is, this culture of overwork has been here for decades. But at that time, permanent workers who were, you know, working very, very long hours, they were offered promotions and they were offered high salaries. But right now, there's no prospect of them having kids or, you know, having a family.Because their salaries are not just going to go up. And among the young, more than 50% are becoming temporary workers. So they don't know what they're going to be doing a month from now. So the environment of working conditions is, you know, completely changing right now.
COSAI is a labour union for young people. They run a hotline on workplace issues. And for 8 years now, Makoto has been taking calls.
Are you getting more calls now than you used to, or is it improving?
It's not improving. Probably this year we're going to get more than maybe 5,000.
When people call up, what sort of things are you hearing? What are the biggest complaints?
So we get a lot of calls complaining about overwork. And we have another issue of so-called black companies. What they're doing is they're just, you know, treating workers as disposable. So they're hiring 200 people and in 1 year, and 200 people quits in 1 year. And they're hiring 200 another people.
How many people are there out there actually fighting and taking on these companies?
There aren't very many. It's very difficult for anybody in Japan to, you know, stand up for your rights.
But not everyone goes quietly. Workplace bullying and unpaid overtime force one beauty therapist to fight back against her employer.
We're just out here waiting for Miki Tanaka, who has organised a protest against this company. And turns out in Japan, you have to go up and notify the company before you actually do the protest. So she'll be out here in a second.
Hi.
Hello.
I'm Mark.
I'm Miki.
How was your meeting?
Hi. Hi.
Oh, nice to meet you. How was the conversation upstairs?
It was intense. So we asked them to bring their CEO out, but they said the CEO is not here, nor anyone in charge.
Right.
So it's weekday, and saying that the person in charge is not there is very weird.
Miki found herself working each night until 10:30 without the adequate breaks.
What's the sort of mental strain of doing those kinds of hours?
You just cannot think straight about anything. All you're doing is like working like a robot.
I understand at a certain point you had panic attacks.
Yes.
For somebody that's never experienced a panic attack before, what does that feel like?
Horrible.
Yeah?
Like I could not work. The moment I saw my manager's face, I just started breaking down, and I just could not work. I started shivering, shaking.
Miki says when she finally worked up the courage to quit, her manager didn't lodge her resignation. She was trapped.
To be honest, I kind of felt like giving up with my life, but when I was going through it, my mom was in Japan, and she just asked me to quit the job. Like, you don't need to die for the company, is what she said.
But that's just the thing. All across Japan, people are dying for the company. Last financial year, 190 people officially died or attempted suicide from overwork. In fact, Japan has one of the highest suicide rates in the developed world, higher than the US, higher than the UK, and yes, higher than Australia. Jiro Ito is a psychiatrist. He runs a not-for-profit that works to prevent suicides among young people by catching those who search the internet for how to die before they go through with it. When Jiro started this organisation in 2013, the phrase, "I want to die," was being searched 130,000 times a month. Now, it's almost double that. This is Dentsu. It is Japan's biggest advertising agency, and 3 years ago, one of their employees took her own life. Her name was Matsuri Takahashi, and she was 24 years old. And in the months leading up to her death, she was clocking around 100 hours of extra overtime a month. Now, when the courts ruled, they said that she literally died of overwork. And in Japan, they have a word for that. It's called karoshi. Now, Dentsu was fined 500,000 yen, which in Australian dollars amounts to about $6,000. But the crucial thing is this: not one manager, no one, was held accountable for her death. It took just 8 months for Matsuri to go from this bright university graduate to ending it all on the fourth floor of a company dormitory. How does that happen? what could possibly have driven her to that place? Well, Matsuri may be gone, but she did leave us some clues. Outside Tokyo is Susano. This is where Matsuri Takashi grew up.
I was very young. 挑戦をし続けて、日本では本当にトップ企業と言われている会社に自分の力で入社したけど、それ力が尽きてしまったと。彼女の生き様というものは彼女の努力だけではどうにもならなかったと。
We now know that Matsuri was working up to 7 days, and at its worst, on just 10 hours sleep a week. The division at Dentsu was halved, and the workload doubled. And in the midst of it, she tweeted.
クリスマスイブの日で会社で仕事をしていました。私のオフィスに警察から電話がかかってきました。
I understand that Matsuri left you a message. What did it say?
お母さん、今までありがとう。自分を責めないでねという。人生も仕事も人生も全てが辛いです。さようならと。
Does the pain of losing a child get easier?
2年と6ヶ月ほど過ぎましたけど、とても傷が癒えるというところには至っていません。日本の働く環境が彼女だけではない、彼女のような人の人生を奪っているということを知ってほしいと。
When I heard the news of Takahashi-san, well, I thought, well, it happened again. So that was the third time Karoshi happened at that company, Dentsu.
The head of Dentsu stepped down. There was a token fine. What would have been a sufficient punishment for Dentsu, do you think?
Well, that's a difficult question because, you know, punishing Dentsu is not going to solve this problem. This is not just a Dentsu problem. This is a problem of...which is happening in every single workplace.
Matsuri Takahashi's death in 2015 refocused Japan's attention on Karoshi. In June this year, the government set a legal limit on the amount of overtime staff can work to 100 hours extra a month. But that is 20 hours more than what the government also say will put you at risk of Karoshi.
It's just ridiculous. The government's saying that you have a chance to die, but you can work till this limit.And there is no law that the company has to follow on keeping the actual number of hours that a worker works. So they can just forge timesheets. They can just not record anything.
Why do you think the laws that they put in place were so open to interpretation and possible abuse?
A lot of companies and business agencies donating huge amounts of money to the government and the ruling party.
The Japanese government have dedicated millions to try and get more people dating and marrying. But what if the answer to the problem in Japan's bedrooms can only be solved in Japan's boardrooms?
まあ僕もそうですけど、まあ労働時間が長かったり、まあ休日出勤が普通だったりする環境もあるし。 まあ、そういうふうになっちゃう人がいても、まあ、おかしくない環境っていうのは今の日本の社会には、まあ、大手もベンチャーも限らずあるんじゃないのかなと。
Tomorrow, Tayo will still want to climb that corporate ladder, while others, like Yuki, will seek to rewrite the rules of Japanese society.
必ずそこで変えていく力、間違っているものは正す力が必要だと思います。
Why is it important for you to stand here and talk about this?
世界の人たちに知ってもらえるということ、日本の現状がひどい現状を、私は今でも娘が亡くなる以前の自分のような元気を取り戻してはいません。もう息をすることすら苦しい長い時間がただ過ぎていくばかりです。時が苦しみを癒すようなことは一生ないと思っています。